Yeah, Young the Giant, they've been around for years. In fact, the singer of that song came from a different band that the name escapes you right now, which is also, look up the history of that guy, and you'll find some good shit.
I guarantee he's part of the influence.
Yeah, totally. And then the Shins, you know the Shins?
No, none of those either.
They got the fucking Shins, dude. Yeah.
They're pretty good.
Yeah, dude.
Pretty
it's good. Like, it's mellow. It's like this, it's kind of like if you have a few beers in you, or you have...
This... When I first heard this, I was not listening. Like I mentioned, I wasn't listening to this time. What do you call this? Like, this is like indie-ish?
It's, indie-esque. I would say indie-esque. Folky. Right, folky, yeah, indie,
folky,
I would say.
Folk, yeah, I mean, I guess it qualifies it because they got a fucking tambourine in there, but... Right. But yes.
Wait, I think this guy, these guys... these guys and, they have the Moon-Shaped Pool album.
You got me, man. I don't know.
I'm a weirdo, I'm a freak.
I'm a weirdo,
I'm a weirdo, I'm a freak.
Come on, man, you're gonna anyway, all of this.
We'll come back. We'll come back to it. But these guys very much. These guys growing up, I listened to them and I kind of found my voice through them. Okay. They're singing this song, yeah. Kind of like the higher register kind of style. So very much an influence when singing.
Yeah, his voice is pretty. His voice is very, very good.
Yeah, dude,
it's like awesome. Velvet.
Yeah,
it's so smooth.
Like butter.
The last song that I brought to the table today, and this is one of mine, Josh. Can you fucking believe it after you hear it? It's, well, you know how much of a fan I am of Rage Against the Machine.
Yes, sir.
That's my favorite band of all time.
You even got a flag that you tried to put up in the living room.
I did put it up in the living room.
Tried. It fell.
And back in 1998, the waters were looking a little, you know, like things weren't going really well with Rage Against the Machine. Granted, they put out their Battle of Los Angeles album. Mm-hmm. Renegades came out after that a couple of years, which is just really an album of covers. But I'm glad to see that Zack De La Rocha was still trying to keep busy, the singer, the vocalist of Rage Against the Machine.
Yeah.
And you guys know who KRS-One is, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, legends. Legends in the hip-hop world. The Last Emperor also has something to do with this. It doesn't belong to any one artist. It came out of this compilation album called The Lyricist Lounge, Volume 1. Came out back in 1998. So he was still in Rage Against the Machine, mind you, but... Zack De La Rocha, man, that guy is one of my most favorite lyricists of any genre. He would transcend any genre because it's more like a poetry that's really politically, soulfully charged, and he does it so fucking well. And dude, you guys will know. I mean, this song was made for Zack De La Rocha. The song is him, so it highlights his ability to be who he is as a lyricist without Rage Against the Machine backing him up. So as we heard with Audio Slave, when those boys were doing their thing with Chris Cornell, now you get to see Zack De La Rocha in what would be considered, in my opinion, more or less his element, which he doesn't utilize enough. So enjoy the shit out of this song called C.I.A., in parentheses, Criminals in Action, with Zack De La Rocha, KRS-One, and The Last Emperor.
KRS-One coming through. Big Zack, Last Emperor. That's the sound of EMS. Last Emperor KRS. Big Zack, you know the rest. Now we gonna come down like this now. Hold tight, all crew. Listen.
This voice shatters the calm of the day like an alarm. So wake up, batter you, and take up arms. Cause more is necessary than vocabulary war. Cause a toxic rock impulse hitting on your door. CIA, I see you later. Cause your time is coming soon. I flip this shit like Pacino and it's your dog day afternoon. Attica, Attica, drug agents, you bring your statica. My alphabet will slash that neck and flip you. Automatica, dramatic, like Ali Shaheed Muhammad brought the vibes. I bring the sun at red dawn upon the thoughts of France Fanon. So stand in attention, devil dirge. You never survive choosing sides against the wretched of the earth. The infiltrator, child intoxicator, people incarcerator, liberation movement annihilator. We got you clock pushing rocks in the fair. We got brothers trooping subways like the Ho Chi Minh Trail. We got the truth at it. Last emperor KRS in history manifested. Tomorrow the next lesson.
You claim I'm selling crack, but you be doing that.
Yeah, what do you think of that shit?
Dude, that's fucking badass. You had this?
Yeah.
You had this.
This is coming from me.
That beat is shocking. Just like fat.
Oh, dude, that beat is so.
And you got Zack LaRocha just spitting.
Oh my god,
dude. Blew that off, man.
Yeah, man, he went on really well, dude. I always forget how fucking well he fucking raps.
It's because like. He was in an average size. He was an average sized fish in an average sized pond when he's up against Timmy C on bass.
That's true.
Tom Morello on guitar.
That's true.
And fucking Brad Wilk on drums, dude. And when they're all greats doing the best that they can do at what they do.
Yeah, that is true.
It's like four fucking giants. But when you put him in this setting, he shines like a motherfucker, dude. Like he holds his own with KRS-One and Last Emperor, man. Dude.
This is dope. This is great.
And you know what, dude? I was on Apple Music last night. I was just kind of type because I had intentions to play this song. I was like, I just hope fucking Apple Music has it so I can play it. And when I typed in Zack LaRocha, would you believe that he did a song with Los Tigres del Norte?
No.
Recently. Fucking Mexican fucking norteña band.
Okay, that's why it sounded familiar to me. I'm sorry. You want that paisa band?
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely. I'm talking about the paisa band. He grabs a 12-string guitar. He gets on stage. And then would you believe that Tigres del Norte started playing Killing in the Name?
Oh, no way.
Briefly. Oh, like they briefly, like the because it was like an MTV Unplugged situation.
Okay.
So the bass, he didn't have a bass. He had a big fucking stand-up bass.
Yeah.
As opposed to like a regular bass or a guitarrón, depending on you know, how they're playing their shit. But you saw everybody was using acoustics. So yeah. Unplugged. So he shows up with a 12-string. And he just starts jamming with them, but like it's a specific song of Tigres del Norte about how even the most heartfelt Mexicans are still better Americans than some of the Americans in this country now. At least that's the message of that song.
Yeah.
And if you were to translate it, those are pretty good lyrics. I mean, I'm not a fan of the genre. But I mean, he did him good. He did a good job for him. I mean, check that shit out. It's probably on YouTube and all.
Was
that
it like
shit.
They go like "Killing in the Name"?
Yeah, a little bit. Like you know the part where it goes da na na na, the accordion does that part. But that day it was just like for like that. Old two note Sanchez in the back.
Sanchez.
So, nevertheless, I know Zack LaRocha's done other shit. Like he did that project called "One Day as a Lion" later on in his like a few years later when after he, I believe it was just him on the keyboard synthesizer with the drummer of the Mars Volta. So, you guys are familiar with Mars Volta,
yes.
Right? That drummer is an insane motherfucker.
Oh,
like that guy,
yes.
That guy kills it every time. So I was just excited. Anything that Zack LaRocha puts out, in my opinion, is just worth checking out because it's worth listening to. When Zack left, it was a kick in the nuts to the rock and roll genre.
Yeah, big time.
Luckily, Audio Slave was still like it kept it going, like that sound. But you didn't have Zack with his lyrics.
No, it felt like just another Soundgarden, like a better sounding Soundgarden, because you had Tom Morello on there, and you know, and Timmy C and Brad, and it actually sounded great. But when you heard that sound, like when you heard Morello's like solos and stuff, you expected Zack De La Rocha's vocals to be there. So it was kind of like a little off.
Yeah,
you know, I felt a little off for a while, like a little while about it.
But when he comes out with like projects like this, dude, you have to just check it out to see what this guy's up to, what he's been writing. In fact, it had been a few years after they had broken up, and me and my buddy Anthony, who's the host of Gay Music for All podcast. Everybody should check that out if you're into hip hop and other kinds of shit that raps about like video games. It's dope. Like it's a specific niche, but it's enjoyable as fuck. I've been to a couple of their events, and you got like DJs that hook up their equipment to like old Nintendo shit.
I've heard about that.
And you get the 8-bit sound coming out of it, and then they're mixing that, and you got rappers coming out rapping to it.
That's fucking
dope. It's crazy. Like there was this band that played at one of the events I went to that just played songs and sang about Mega Man.
Nice.
Yeah.
That's dope.
It was crazy. It was crazy. You would never think, like, who would come together as a group and just and dedicate...
Think of this.
Like. And dedicate their time to this. But, dude, they did a really good job. And all those artists that kids, because they're fucking into it, you know? Right. So it comes out as genuine as fuck. And they put it together.
Where
did
they,
and it's
where
great.
Perform these at?
I don't know that he's taking a little bit of a hiatus. I expect him, and I'll get
what's
with
it
him
called?
About it. Game the Music event. For All. Game Music for All event.
Game or gate?
Game.
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 Game. Game. Okay. Yes. Enunciate, Josie. Enunciate.
Sorry, Game Music for All, the number 4all.com. I always have a good time listening to his shit, and I've been trying to get him on, but he's been really busy trying to get his podcast going.
Uh-huh.
But dude, it's good. I where the fuck was I?
I don't know. I honestly don't know.
This
got away from me. I'll be honest with you. This got away from me.
Right. I went to the Natural History Museum in Los Angeles with this guy. And yeah, I know, right? And then, so we went
good
there.
Good thing it's game for music and not gay for
right.
music.
Game.
Right.
Game.
Thank you. So we went there because Zack La Rocha was going to be playing with a Mexican folk band and like an indigenous style kind of folky band. And so we went there because, shit, I mean, it's the only thing Zack La Rocha has ever done live for you to buy a ticket to and go to. We were just out of high school. We went there and shit, like we're going to get there early because I want to fucking see some dinosaur bones. And we get to the Natural History Museum particularly early, and there he fucking is just smoking a cigarette, like, and I at that time I remember Zack having the dreads, the long fucking dreads that he had in the last couple albums, but no, he cut the dreads, and in the meantime he was just growing out this huge fro. So I'm like, is that Zack? Is that not Zack? Fucking looks like him. And there he fucking was. I'm like, hey dude, I think that's Zack. He's like, it doesn't look like him based on his hair. I was like, yeah, but look at him. He looks like Zack.
Yeah.
He's like, yeah. And then he noticed that we noticed him. And he's just like, oh, great.
Big shit. Here we go.
And then he's just like, what's up, guys? What are you up to? We're just like, we're just here to see you, dude. And we just started asking him some questions. Too bad one of his handlers kind of like took him away. I guess they timed his cigarette time.
Yeah.
And they opened the door. They're just like, we got to go get ready. And he's like, cool, thanks. He's like, nice talking to you guys. So we talked to him for like a solid 2 minutes.
Oh, all right.
And he was just telling us what he's been up to. And like, he's like, I wish I could put out more shit. But, you know, it's just a lot of the times it's just politics. And I wish I could be busier. But, you know, I can't complain. You know, I
still living it.
He's still living
still
it.
Still living it.
And he's a talented motherfucker. So, yeah, that was my interaction with Zack La Rocha.
Did you come in your pants
a
after
bit,
talking to him?
Yeah. A little bit. A little bit. I mean, I was...
sure to wear your rubber underwear, though, that day, right?
Of course.
Yeah, good boy.
He's
good boy.
Zach, good boy.
I know what I'm about, son.
He's like, I'm going to see Zack De La Rocha. Got to put my rubber undies.
So enough about me.
Thank God.
Anonymous, Jesus. Where can we find you again one more time?
Yeah, you can find me on Instagram at AnonymousMC94, and you can go on my website, AnonymousMC.com. You can listen to my music straight from the website, or if not, you can click on one of the hyperlinks to take you to Spotify, iTunes, YouTube, everything, you know, etc.
Sick, man.
Right on, dude.
I appreciate you being on. Maybe we'll have you on again.
Thank you for having, man.
Yeah,
it depends on how many music videos you can dish out, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I'm
going to keep it going, bro.
I hope so, man. Right? I hope so. I enjoyed the shit out of your stuff. Now, Nuncio, where can we find your company, your brand? How can we get more involved with your shit?
I have so many things going on. Okay, so first, you can follow what Anonymous is signed to Vision X ENT on Instagram. It's on Facebook as well. It's on every major platform. And then personally, with what's going on with myself as a singer, as a creative, as an entrepreneur, at Nuncio X, you can follow my band, which I'm fronting, Wolves Inside Band. And yeah, that's it.
Sweet, man. And shit, dude, maybe we can collab on some shows in the near future with the Fallen Electric.
Please.
That would be dope as fuck.
Be tight.
Yeah, man. Well, thank you all very much for listening into the Foo Bar Show. Thank you for downloading the pod on most podcast apps and subscribing and telling a friend like a fucking champion. You can always reach us at FooBar Show. That's FOOBarShow.com. And FOOBarShow is our handle on Facebook, Tumblr, Twitter, and Instagram. You can check us out. Drop us a line and we'll fill it up like a couple of foos. I've been Josie.